Hello friends, welcome to Ashtak channel. In my last video, you have seen how to execute a ARM based program, the program which is written in assembly language. In the last program, we took two values and we added two values by using three registers. In today's program, we will continue arithmetic and logical operation on ARM controller. Let me start. Now, kill Microvision 4. So, we have already a source group. Otherwise, if you want, you can create a new Microvision project. So, for this one, to create the new Microvision project, you refer my last video. Let me now use already created source group. And I will add the file. Let me add the files which I have created in my last video. Add file. Here you have to select ASM file. In the last video, I have created add is.asm. Let me open this first file. And you can see the last program which we had written, this one, which will add two numbers. Now let me close this program now and remove this file from the source group. Please remember, I am removing this file from the group. I am not deleting the file. Remove this file from the group. Now let me add some other file to the group. So this time I will take sub23.asm, close it and open the program. You can see this program is used for subtraction. So once again, in the last class I told you title of the program. So before starting the program, give one tab in the code window. So area equivalent to segment area, and the name of the area, it is a label program and it is used for code purpose, and it is stored in read only memory. I have taken two numbers in the hexadecimal format, 7 and 6. How will you come to know it is a number? So because it is preceded by hash. So SUBS R2 R1 R0, what is the meaning of this one? What is the meaning of this one? That means R2 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 will contain, R2 is nothing but R1 and minus R0, R1 minus R0, R2 is nothing but R1 minus R0. So what is R1 in our case? In our case, R1 is 6. 6 minus 0, naturally it results in borrow. So 6 minus 0 is minus 1, naturally it results in borrow. When there is a borrow, your carry flag in this case becomes 0. Please remember, during the subtraction, carry flag becomes 0. During the addition, if there is a carry, then carry flag becomes 1 in case of ARM. So, SUBS, what is this instruction, SUBS? SUBS instruction shows the status of a flag register. SUBS shows the status of a flag register. Let me execute this program. So go to Let me execute the program. We'll go to translate. You can see zero errors here. Then build and rebuild. Once this is done, you go to debug, evaluation mode, click on OK. And here we'll see now, we'll execute one by one, step by step. First 7 will be in R0, second 6 will be in this one. R2 contains this one, 2's complement, because 6 minus 7, as I said, it is minus 1. How will you come to know? So you can see here, carry is 0. Now let me reverse the number. So I will stop the debug. I will close, I will reverse the number here now. I will make R0 is equal to 6 and R1 is equal to 7. Let me store the program once again, save the program and translate, build and rebuild. Let me debug the program. So step by step instruction, 1, 6, R0 is 6, R1 is 7, then 7 minus 6 is equal to 1. This time we will see our carry flag is equal to 1. This indicates doesn't indicate there is a borrow. This indicates result is a positive number. The result is a positive number. So this is the program. So let me stop the debug once again and let me close the program and let me remove this file. Remove this file. Yeah, file is removed. Now let me add some other files. Once again, add files to the group. Let me take here file. I will select assembly language file. So let me take file from my folder. The file is I will take the file uml.23.es. Close. So uml multiplication mu, for multiplication mul we use uml is equal to uml is nothing but it is used for the long multiplication. So when you use long multiplication, then you cannot use normally opcode like move or command like move. This time you will use the command like LDR, load register. It will load the register from memory. Here you can see the number, 32 bit number I have taken, 32 bit number. This is nothing but 32 bit number. One more number I have taken, 32 bit. And you know 32 bit and 32 bit number multiplication normally results in 64 bit. So to store the number, I have taken 2 more register. That means the meaning of this line is it will multiply R0 and R1 and the result is stored in R2 and R3. This is unsigned multiplication. The result is stored in R2 and R3. Let me execute this program. Once again build, translate, zero errors. After that go to debug, then execute it. First number is in first register, second number, and our third and fourth register contains multiplication. But how will you confirm this one? For this one you have to go to use your calculator. Let me use the calculator here. So I will use my calculator and I will go to view programmer mode. In programmer mode, hexadecimal mode, I will type the number here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This is a 32 bit number, first number, multiply by second number is 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4. So is equal to, you can see this is the number like 3B86A, and this one. Let me use magnifier here. See, this is the number, this one. So here R3 contains lower bytes and our R2 contains upper byte. This is upper byte 3B, which starts with the 3B, and lower byte is 170. Here you can see 170. So stop debug, close the program, remove this program from group, remove this file from group, yes, add one more file now. Add files to the group. Yeah, let me add the file. Add files to the group. This time I will add one more file. I will go to my folder and here I will add memory.asm. Close. Here you can see data transfer from the memory. This program is data transfer from memory. So my dear students, in my last video, I have shown you how to add two numbers, and this video we have started with the subtraction, we started with the unsigned long multiplication. After that we now started how to transfer data from memory. So once you complete this one, then we'll see division instruction. The specialty of ARM is most of the instructions are executed in, 90% of the time instructions are executed in register, because ARM contains a long set of registers. Around 37 registers are there. Only two instructions we are using for memory related operation, that is LDR and STR. So now here, now I am going to use indirect addressing mode. You know what is addressing mode? Addressing mode is the way in which we will pass the operand to the instruction. So first line TTL, memory transfer program, second line area, and area, the name of the area is program. You can give any name, comma, space, and it is used for code, comma, and it is stored only, read only. Now I'll take register R0. In the register R0, I will use one 32-bit value. This 32-bit value indicates memory. It is the address of the memory. That I will move into R0. After that, I will move the content of the R0 to R1. Now I will increment R0 by 4. That is, initially, let me use pen now. Initially the memory was started with the 0x4 and followed with the how many zeros? That is 7 zeros, because each zero will take 4 bit. 7 0 means 4 sevens are 28, and this one 4 takes 4 bits, 32 bits data. Initially R0 memory address is this one, and I will transfer the content of this one to one register, that is R1, by using LDR instruction. Then I will increment this one by 4. Now this becomes I will not write here, this becomes 40004. Now I will transfer the content of this register to R2. Are you getting my point? Yes, my dear students. Now I will add with the S. What is S? S indicates flag status. It shows the flag status. So R1 and R2 is added and content is stored in R3 and simultaneously it will show the flag status. Now, we have one command here, bcclc. The command is unconditional branch, branch carry clear, branch carry clear. If there is no, if the carry is clear, if the carry bit is zero, then it will jump to this one. If the carry bit is 1, then it will add 1 to the register R4. It will add 1 to the register R4. I am taking one more register to show the carry. So if there is no carry, it will jump to this one, this line. And here what it will do, here it will once again, it will increment R0 by 4. So once again, it will add R0. Once again, it will add R0 by 4. Now, first location is this one, second location is this one, third location, this is 8. Third location is 8. So, in this location, the result is stored. And once again, R0 is added with the 4. Now, this becomes in hexadecimal C. In this location, carry is stored. Then LBL and end. So in this way, this works. So now the student, the program is already written. Now what you have to do is you have to save the program. Save the program, then translate it. Assemble it, then build it, then rebuild it. So you can see zero errors. Unless and until zero errors, you cannot proceed. Once this is done, my dear students, we can go to debug mode. So in debug mode, so here, my dear students, you have to start with the memory window. So let me go to memory window and you have to start with the memory window. So let me close this symbol window, close this window also. So yeah, the stack window. So now let me start memory window. You can see a memory window. This is the memory window. Now, in the memory window, I will type here 0x, my memory starts with 4, 0, 0, 2, 0, 3, 0, 4, 0, 5, 0, 6, 0, 7, 0, enter. This is my memory. So, in this memory, what I will do is here, this is 400, this is 1, 2, 3. So this is memory block 0, 1, 2, 3. Then one more, this one is 4, 5, 6, 7. So here I will store the data. Let me store here 0, 5. My data is 5. Yes? Yeah. Then here I will store, let me store here 6. 5 and 6, when it will add 5 and 6, you know, you should get the value B. Yes. Once this is done, go to program, this one execution step by step. So now it will execute. You can see now the first number 5 is loaded from the memory. Second number 6 is now the R0 is incremented by 4. Now it will jump to the second number here. Second number here. It will jump to second number, this one, second number. So you can see now R2 will be loaded with the 6, yeah, correct. Then R1 and R2 is added. Now R3 contains B. You can see here flag status is equal to, flag status is equal to, you know, that is not, flag status you can see here. It's B, flag is 0. So let me once again minimize it. Then minimize it. So next instruction is store. So once again, this will be incremented. You see here, this is incremented by 8. Now it will jump to this memory location. You see this memory location, and it will store the result in that memory location. See, you can see here that it will store the result in this memory location. For in ARM, memory locations are always a block of 4 locations, because it is a 32-bit processor, and it is the architecture is 32-bit processor, address is also 32-bit, and data is also 32-bit. That's why it will take 4 memory locations to store the data. Like first location in the first chip, second location in the like this location in the first chip, this location in the second chip, this location in the third chip, this location in the fourth chip. So that is called as a bank. First bank, second bank, third bank, fourth bank, something like this. So like this, you can see. So now the number this is stored, and finally when you execute it, it will loop here. So this is memory related operation. Like this, you can execute for a subtract instruction also. Please remember, in the case of subtract, a borrow is there, carry flag becomes a 1. And here also you can take the long number. Let me take 5, and here it is 6, 6, and here it is, let me take FF, here it is, let me take 4, 4, and let me, this number always FF, let me take this number FF only, that is maximum number I am taking, this number FF. Clear? Let me now reset. Now you can see the pointer moves to the first instruction. Execute now. The first number is loaded. Can you see the first number is loaded? Yeah. The first number is loaded in the order. You see the order, the first number is loaded. The second number is loaded now. See. Now the result is stored in... You see that this is the result, and you will see the flag here. Flag this time carry is there, and carry flag is 1, and that should be stored in one more location here. So our program is not completed. Let me proceed now. So you can see now carry flag 1 will be stored here in the other location. 1 will be stored in the other location. So this is with the carry. This is with the carry. So with this we complete memory transfer. Now the next program is division. So let me close this one now, stop the debug, close this one, remove this file. Yes, remove this file, add files. Select the file, division, this time I am going to take division. So let me open the program. You can see here, my dear students, this is a division program. There is no direct division instruction in ARM7. We will perform division by using subtraction. For example, I want to divide, let me use the pen, I want to divide 7 by 5, so what should I do? 7 by 5. I have to compare first 7 and 5. When you compare 7 and 5, then 7 is the bigger number. When 7 is the bigger number, what compare instruction will do? Compare instruction will do 7 minus 5, but will not save the result. 7 minus 5, then there is no borrow. There is no borrow means carry flag is 1. So if carry flag is 1, then we will not increment the register. We will take one more register to store quotient. And remainder will remain in the original register. Suppose if I take 5 minus 7, initially itself carry flag is 0. That means 5 is the remainder and quotient is 0. So we use this logic. So here I have taken number 12, first number, second number is 5. I will compare first number with second number. So 12 minus 5, 12 minus 5, let me take pen once again. Let me use pen once again. 12 minus 5. So 12 minus 5, 12 minus 5 is equal to 12 minus 5, there is no borrow. So carry flag is equal to, this time carry flag is equal to 0, right? Carry flag is equal to 1. And 12 minus 5, carry flag is 1. That time, branch on carry clear. If carry is clear, then you branch to last. Otherwise, if there means carry is 0, then it will loop, it will jump here, this line. Otherwise, it will subtract 12 minus 5. 12 minus 5, it will subtract. What is 12 minus 5? 12 minus 5 is equal to 7. So now R1 holds 7 and R2 remains 5 and this will loop here once again, branch loop. So once again it will compare now 7 and 5. This time it is 7 and 5. So I missed one statement. Meanwhile, I am going to increment the register here, R3 1. So here R3 becomes 1. One subtraction is over. Now 7 minus 5. Once again, 7 minus 5. Carry flag is equal to 1. That means bigger number. That means this time 7 minus 5, R1 becomes 2. And R5 is equal to 5 only. And once again, R3 register will incremented by 1. R3 register is incremented by 1. Now third iteration, 2 minus 5. This time, you see 2 minus 5, borrow will be there. That time, carry flag becomes 0. When carry flags becomes 0, see carry flags branch clear carry last, it will come here. If the carry is 0, it will come and it will end. Means it will end the program. That time remainder is stored in R1 register and quotient is stored in R3 register. R3 contains 2 and R1 contains 2. That means when you divide 12 by 5, you will get quotient 2 and remainder 2. This is the meaning of this one. Is it clear, my dear friends? Let's now execute the program. You just see here. I will stop this one. Let us execute the program first. 0 errors, build this one. Okay, go to debug, click on OK. So now you can see here, first number R1 is loaded with the 12. So let me execute R1. Then second number R1 in hexadecimal format, it is hexadecimal format, the number is C. Please remember, I have taken decimal number that will be converted into hexadecimal C. Then second number is 5. So now C minus 5, you can see carry flag, this time carry flag is 1, there is no borrow. Like this, it will repeat here, you can see it will repeat. And you can see the answer here, R1 contains 2 and our R3 contains 2. So that is the answer we got. So this is the program related to division. So here there is no direct DIV instruction like MUL and SUB. We are using this method for division. So with this, friends, I have covered arithmetic operation. In the next video, we will see logical operations. After that, how to write the program in higher level language in Keel, because ARM supports both assembly language and high level language also. Thank you.